it's an incredible honor. I think the first thing that came into my head when I found out was just that I get tied to a place, a university that's so meaningful to my life, both in terms of the time spent there growing up from, you know, a 17, 18 year old kid and maturing there and so making so many great friends that are still friends today. But also I met my wife there. We still come back and love to get back. So to just be associated with a place that, you know, is so meaningful both to Rebecca and I mean, it's incredible. And to be tied to that for forever is kind of a neat, it's hard to explain. Like it's such a neat accomplishment and something that I just never thought of when going to Mac at all. So I'm super excited, and plus I get to go in and there are some former teammates in there as well. So it's an incredible opportunity or accomplishment, I guess. I'm really grateful. There's a couple. I mean, winning that first Yates Cup, well, I mean, my only Yates Cup, but winning that Yates Cup in 03 stands out. And part of it, I think, is that it was the first game I ever started, actually. So randomly, I was starting my first game, and it was the Yates Cup, and I was, you know, super nervous. And I don't remember a lot from it. It all kind of seems like a blur, but what I remember is Brandon Little took a kickoff return for a touchdown. It just seemed to kind of ease everybody's nerves. And then the next thing I know, I'm trying to fight my way into the picture with the Yates Cup and just try to get in there. And when you talk about like memories and what does it mean to be part of the Hall of Fame, and it's just the pride in the school. And I think one of my biggest memories came actually at the Vanier Cup in Vancouver. Obviously, we were years removed from it. But the guys that flew in and made an effort to get there to watch that game together, and the pride of watching someone win, that's probably one of my favorite memories. And it happened years after my playing time. So that those relationships that you built and that we built and over my time at Mac were incredible. And I think that just, it shows up in that experience. Like there's probably 20 guys that flew in from all over the country just to watch and to have the pride of McMaster and watching that team win the Vanier Cup was probably one of my best memories from Mac, and it happened years after. I came to Mac at a time when there was already really great offensive linemen. I mean, there's a handful of them that are already in the Hall of Fame, like, and two of them that I played with, and I always kind of felt like they set the bar really high, and I just didn't want to let them down, to be honest. I didn't want to be that generation that, let the expectations fall. And I wanted to take them higher. And I just really wanted to feel like when I left after 4 years, the lessons that I took from those guys, I used them to get better and hopefully lifted the bar for the next group. And that was kind of, that was a big part of it. They set a pretty high bar with a lot of expectations, and I just always felt like I wanted to meet those. I really didn't want to let them down. I mean, it was a combination of things. So looking at, you know, potentially where could I go to school, you know, Mac had an awesome team. Obviously, they were in the middle of winning their third Yates Cup in a row, hadn't lost a game in the OUA in years. So obviously an excellent team. But in coming here, I also knew they had a good business school. I was able to get into the commerce program. So I had a good fit just in that in general from a school and a football perspective. And then when I got down here, and at the time it was Coach Marshall and Ted Gavaya doing the recruiting, and I just had a really good relationship with them. And it was the first place I visited. They made me feel like it was a place to fit in and a place that at a young age, they'd give me an opportunity to come in and compete for a spot, even though you had a team that was very senior and very good. And I think that was something that was attractive to me, not because I needed the opportunity to play early, but because I just wanted the opportunity to compete and get better. And if I was able to do that and help the team contribute, then I would have an opportunity. And I think even though they were as good as they were, having that setup coming in was important and really attractive. You know, obviously the first people that came to mind are just my parents. I mean, they're so hardworking, down-to-earth people, kept me grounded. but also instill the discipline about just getting better and really not worrying about what other people were saying, and just kind of focusing on yourself and trying to improve. So that was a great base. I had a great high school coach, Chris Penner. He probably kept my ego in check through high school as I was getting better, knocked me down a few pegs here or there just to make sure that I knew I needed to keep working. And he really set that discipline and a bit of a toughness, to be honest, leaving. And yeah, I mean, I had great teammates, obviously. You know, Dave Ford, he went in the Hall of Fame last year, and Fabio before him, and other great teammates too. You know, Matt O'Mara was a teammate of mine at Mac and in Winnipeg in the pros, and John Paul, the Cercelli, the coach at Windsor. Like, I just had really great teammates that just refused to let the bar come down. And that was such a huge part of my time at Mac, and Coach Riley, I already mentioned. And like, it did take a community, and I was just really lucky along the way to have those types of people that were just committed to me getting the best out of every opportunity. And I was lucky in the CFL the same way. I had a great offensive line coach that did not have to make the investments in me that he did. And it set me up both from a life perspective, some of the lessons I took from him, and allowed me to kind of survive for a few years in the CFL. Like, it takes a community is just, yeah, it's such an understatement, but it's so true. The best piece of advice I got probably in life came from Bob Wiley, my offensive line coach in Winnipeg. He, and I'll tell you a bit of the backstory just quickly. So I got called into his office. They said, bring your playbook in my first training camp. And I, you know, that usually, bring your playbook usually means you're handing it in, and that's kind of the end of it all. I mean, and that's what I expected. And, you know, he basically said, look, he held up two fingers kind of like this and said, do you know what this means? I said, no, I don't know what that means. He's like, this is how much better you need to get every day to make this team. You need to block out everything else and just focus on improving every day. Write things down and say, okay, this is what I'm going to get better at today. And then the next day and the next day, and let those inches build. And I think when it comes to, if I was a student athlete coming in, that's exactly how I would focus on getting better, because there's so much that's going to go on around you and distract you from school, friends, football, and athletics in general, just the time you're going to spend. And am I playing? Am I good enough? You're going to question all those things. But at the end of the day, if you just focus on getting that inch better every single day, everything else will take care of itself. And I think it's the best piece of advice I've got for life after football and into football. And I think if you kind of take that approach when you come in as a student athlete, you'll have all the opportunities that you want, but you sort of have to take that day by day and take it slow and let that build. I think that's the best piece of advice I could give.